In the list of the world's 20 longest-serving leaders who are still in power, Africa boasts of 9, and they occupy the first and the second position with over 40 years' dominance in power. Following the tumult that resulted in the end of Omar al Bashir's nearly 30 years tenure as president of Sudan, we take a look at some of Africa's longest-serving leaders who, after revolutions and coup, still remain in power. Let's get straight into this. Faure Eyadema is a Togolese politician who has been the president of Togo since 2005. Before assuming the presidency, he was appointed by his father, President Nasingbe Eyadema, as Minister of Equipment, Mines, Posts and Telecommunications, serving from 2003 to 2005. Following President Eyadema's death in 2005, Nasingbe was immediately installed as president with support from the army. He then won a controversial presidential election on 24 April 2005 and was sworn in as president. Nasingbe was re-elected for a second term in 2010 and for a third term in April 2015. Hage Geingob is the third and current president of Namibia and has been in office since 21st March 2015. Geingob was the first Prime Minister of Namibia from 21st March 1990 to 28 August 2002 and served as Prime Minister again from 4 December 2012 to 21st March 2015. Between 2008 and 2012, Geingob served as Minister of Trades and Industry. He is also the current president of the ruling SWAPO party since its election to the position in November 2017.
And right at number 8 is a Rwandan politician, Paul Kagame.
Paul Kagame is a Rwandan politician and former military leader. Kagame previously commanded the rebel force that ended the 1994 Rwandan genocide. He was considered Rwanda de facto leader when he served as vice president and minister of defense from 1994 to 2000. He has been described as the most impressive and amongst the most repressive African leaders. In the 1980s, Kagame fought in Yoweri Museveni's rebel army, becoming a senior Ugandan army officer after Museveni's military victories carried him to the Ugandan presidency. He was lastly elected in 2017, and due to yet another change in the constitution, he could potentially be president until 2034. Ismael Guelleh was first elected as president in 1999 as the handpicked successor to his uncle, Hassan Guelleh Abtidon, who had ruled Djibouti since independence in 1977. Guelleh was re-elected in 2005, 2011, and again in 2016. The 2011 election was largely boycotted by the opposition amidst complaints over widespread irregularities. Guelleh has been characterized as a dictator, and his rule has been criticized by some human rights groups.
At number 6 is Eritrean president.
Isaias Afwerki is the first and current president of Eritrea, a position he has held since after the Eritrean War of Independence in 1993. He led the Eritrean People's Liberation Front to victory in May 1991, ending the 30-year-old war for independence. He has been cited for human rights violation by the United Nations and Amnesty International. In 2015, Reporters Without Borders ranked Eritrea under the government of President Isaias Afwerki last in his Press Freedom Index for the 8th year running. General Idriss Deby is a Chadian politician who has been the president of Chad since 1990. He is also head of the Patriotic Salvation Movement. He took power at the head of a rebellion against President Hissine Habré in December 1990 and has since survived various rebellions against his own rule. He won election in 1996 and 2001, and after term limits were eliminated, he won again in 2006, 2011 and 2016. He is a graduate of Muammar Gaddafi's War Revolutionary Center. Yoweri Museveni has been president of Uganda since 1986. Museveni was involved in rebellions that toppled notorious Ugandan leaders Idi Amin and Milton Obote before capturing power in the 80s. In the mid to late 1990s, Museveni was celebrated by the West as part of a new generation of African leaders. During Museveni's presidency, Uganda has experienced relative peace and significant success in battling HIV/AIDS. At the same time, Uganda remains a country suffering from high levels of corruption, unemployment, and poverty. President Museveni had scrapped presidential term limit in 2005 and the presidential age limit in 2017, thus enabling the extension of his rule.
And at number 3 spot is Denis Nkweso of the Republic of the Congo.
Denis Nkweso is a Congolese politician who has been the president of the Republic of Congo since 1997. He was previously president from 1979 to 1992. During his first period as president, he headed the single-party regime of the Congolese Party of Labour for 12 years. He stood as a candidate in the 1992 presidential election, but was defeated. Sassou Nkweso was an opposition leader for 5 years before returning to power during the Second Civil War, in which his rebel forces ousted President Pascal Lissouba. Born on the 5th June 1942, Teodoro Obiang is an Equatoguinean politician who has been president of Equatorial Guinea since 1979. He ousted his uncle Francisco Macias Nguema in an August 1979 military coup and has overseen Equatorial Guinea's emergence as an important oil producer. Beginning in the 1990s, though, he has been widely accused of corruption and abuse of power.
And the number one spot of the top 10 longest serving African rulers goes to Cameroon Paul Biya.
A native of Cameroon South, Paul Biya rose rapidly as a bureaucrat under President Ahmadou Ahidjo in the 1960s, serving as Secretary General of the Presidency from 1968 to 1975, and then as Prime Minister of Cameroon from 1975 to 1982. He succeeded Ahidjo as President upon the latter's surprise resignation in 1982. His regime is supported by France, which supplies it with weapons and trains its repressive forces. France is the leading foreign investor ahead of the United States. Biya is currently the longest ruling non-royal leader in the world and the oldest ruler in Africa. So thank you for watching. Let me know your thoughts on the comment section below. Do subscribe to this channel for more weekly videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter. I will definitely catch you next week for a new video. Peace. I'm out.